We all know how our culture presents Santa Claus. But if you dig beneath some of the layers of myth and history, a very different picture emerges. The real original Saint Nicholas was a real person, and there's a spiritual dimension to his story that's uplifting that you probably will find encouraging. Nicholas was born around 270 AD along the southern coast of what's now Turkey. His parents were wealthy, but they were also Christians, and they faithfully taught him the Bible. Now, Nicholas' parents died when he was a teenager, leaving him a sizable fortune, and despite the temptations that that would represent, Nicholas devoted his life to pursuing God and serving others. And in time, as a young man, he became the pastor of a city in Turkey called Myra. Nicholas used his inherited wealth to bless the people of the city and to take care of the Christians there that were needy. And he'd often go out secretly at night in disguise to deliver money and clothing and food to the neediest residents of the town. And he's especially known for his generosity and compassion to the children of that community. The legends report that he would anonymously throw coins through the windows of people's homes, and sometimes those coins would accidentally land in stockings that were hanging by the fireplace to dry. And when there was no window available, he would put those coins down the chimney in order to anonymously bless those families and take care of their needs. Now, one time he provided dowries for three young women out of a destitute family so they didn't have to end up on the street. And then in the third case, the father caught him, and now people in town understood that Nicholas was responsible for hundreds of acts of benevolence and generosity to the poor people of the city. In 303 AD, the Roman Emperor Diocletian initiated a severe persecution of Christians in the Roman Empire, and Christians were commanded to offer sacrifices to the pagan gods of Rome. Nicholas and thousands of other faithful believers refused to do that. And so he, like many, was thrown into jail before he was finally released when he went back to his pastorate in the city of Myra, where he served the people of God there for another 30 years. Nicholas died on December 6th, around 380 AD. December 6th became celebrated as St. Nicholas Day, and over time his fame and his influence spread throughout all of Europe, that Nicholas became over the centuries the patron saint of Russia, of Greece, of many individual cities. He became the patron saint of children, of sailors, even of pawnbrokers and others. It wasn't long before, in many countries, the celebration of Nicholas Festival began to merge with the celebration of Christmas later in the month. And the Santa Claus figure began to emerge in many different lands and many different names, and often the St. Nicholas story would be blended and melded in with some character from local folklore. Often what they all had in common was an old man with a white beard who gave gifts to children. The American version of Santa Claus owes a lot to the Dutch who settled in what's now New York. And they united the Santa Claus, St. Nicholas figure with a benevolent magician from Nordic legends who is known for punishing bad children and rewarding good children with gifts. Now, when you take Nicholas's habit of giving in secret, primarily to children, and then you add to that the Dutch custom of giving and receiving gifts on St. Nicholas Day, December the 6th, this gave rise to a lot of the customs that are common in the American practice of Christmas, the American understanding of Santa Claus today. Today's Santa still bears some resemblance to St. Nicholas. The clothes that he wears are reminiscent of the robes that a pastor in the ancient world would have worn. The robes were red to stand for the blood of Christ, which was shed for us on the cross for our salvation. And the red was trimmed in white as a sign of purity and holiness, both of Christ and of his people. And it's said that when St. Nicholas grew old, that he began to grow a long white beard. Of course, Christmas is not about St. Nicholas, but if you're a follower of Jesus Christ, there's a lot to remember and celebrate about this man. We can be inspired by his generosity and compassion for children. He was a humble and dedicated servant of Jesus Christ. He loved the Lord, and he endured suffering and persecution for Christ. If Nicholas were alive today, he would probably refuse all the attention that our culture wants to give him. He never drew attention to himself. He'd want to probably simply be known as Nicholas, a servant of Jesus Christ.